I want to see a scene. I want to see J.P. Riddles at Thanksgiving dinner with his niece and nephew, and we'll see if JPC can do it.
Ooh, this will be our biggest challenge yet.
No, it won't. It'll be my biggest challenge yet. You have to do nothing.
Hi, Uncle JP Riddles. Can you pass the rolls?
Okay, pass the rolls. Here's the keys to my Rolls Royce. Just kidding. That's a lawnmower with a little lawn chair riding on top of it. I call it my Rolls Royce, but really what it is it's a riding mower that I turned into a standing mower. Oh, boy, what are you kids doing here?
We're here for Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving, that's right. I said I'd host this year. And
we're thankful for you, Uncle JP.
My tree's a mess. All right, come up under the branches.
Yeah, what is this, JP? What is this tree?
This is my apartment. I leased this from my landlord. Now my landlord's a squirrel, but he's got a big gray beard, so he's wise.
Uncle JP Riddles.
Uh-huh.
We're... Like my brother said, we're so thankful for you, so we thought we didn't want you to spend the holiday alone.
Oh, that's very nice of you, but I'm never alone. I've got the ghost of my past haunting me wherever I go.
Is this harp in the corner your bed?
That's our... That's a harpoon, actually.
I'm dumb.
It's a helix sleep harpoon. Ain't nothing like a great night's sleep on a sharp, rusty, underwater fish sword.
You'll have a whale of a night.
That's true.
Nice. Uncle J.P. Riddle.
Yes, what's going on?
Did you watch the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade
this
morning?
Yeah, did you watch the Macy's Thanksgiving Day?
I did watch the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, but I gotta say that I was pretty dicey for me because me and Underdog have quite a rivalry.
Oh,
the balloon?
Nope, not the balloon. The man the balloon's based on.
The Underdog?
Mm-hmm.
You mean Sam Rockwell's acting career?
How old are you? Never mind. Kids, come up into the tree, and I wanna tell you. Now I'm glad that I just invited you and not your judgmental parents. But Thanksgiving
they're
is...
They're just judges. That's what their job is. They're a judge.
Well, actually, technically, they were both disbarred, or they should be, when the court gets my letter. But I did write it in squirrel blood, and I made my landlord mighty mad. But I've been borrowing that from him. But I wanted to tell you kids what I'm thankful for this Thanksgiving.
What, Uncle JP?
Can you read a Swan Lumps that talks about what you're thankful for?
I absolutely can. I have prepared a Swan Lumps for this very occasion.
Aww.
Swan Lumps 159.
His eyes are rolling back into his head to where it's only white.
Swan Lumps 159, the man who fell out of the tree on Thanksgiving Day. Well, it was a brisk and cold February morning. And
that's
it wasn't
redundant.
Nowhere near Thanksgiving, but the old man in the tree decided that he had been a wise way. He wanted to see his niece and nephew and hope that they could maybe steal some money from their parents. So he sent them a Thanksgiving letter, and he sent it to their school so no one would find it. And the kids came unwittingly to the tree. Now, the tree was not a load-bearing tree because it's more of a shrub. And it's at the governor's mansion. That old man could not keep his weight balance in that tree, and he plummeted right out, and he smacked his head on the ground. Oh, but
he was okay, right?
Well, of course he was okay. He was telling the story. In fact, smacking his head on the ground, he went to the school nurse. Now, the school nurse was the only nurse that would see him because he's not allowed back in the hospital anymore because he would steal the penicillin. And the school nurse took pity on him, and she said, you know, what you need is, you just need a nice place to stay. And he said, can I stay here in the school? And she said, well, that would be horribly inappropriate. And she called the police, and he ended up staying in jail. And so he spent his Thanksgiving, February through April, in a jail cell. But you know what, kids? He deserved it.
Oh, what a great story.
Are you ready for Thanksgiving dinner?
Yeah.
We're going to eat a live squirrel. Get your squirrel forks.
Wait.
I'm coming for you, landlord.
Uncle JP?
Uh-huh.
Why does this postage stamp have wife written on it?
Oh, boy. Well, kids, it's about time you met old J.P. Riddle's wife.
This stamp?
Uh-huh. She's a forever stamp, so she'll always stay young.
See?